from the car park, walk along this track with the lodges on your left hand side, and keep walking and you'll come to the bottom of Puck's Glen. Right, this is the start of the actual Puck's Glen. Sign there telling you potential for falling or fallen debris on the trail after heavy rain. From here onwards, basically you're following the burn all the way up and you are climbing most of the time. There is a couple of steep bits, but nothing too much that you're reasonably fit. It's a good walk.
Summer sun with you, I've always known you good. You're close from both. I feel your skin, the sea is cold. I'm falling into your soul, and I'll forever dwell. I can't believe we are one. And
the best thing to do is just take your time.
No rush. The squeal and swine, the swirl and brine, I'm yours and you are mine.
And as you can see, most places where they may be a little difficult, there is handrails. The thing to remember about walking up here is it can get slippery, especially in some places where there's exposed roots.
Yeah.
And you can see here, there's the remains of another path, but that's been blocked off. I think it's due to this, the face of this, the rock face here. There might be problems with it. You know, I don't know how many times I've said it when I've been up here, and I've been up here in the winter when it's been heavy with snow, which is spectacular, by the way. This place always seems to remind me of a scene from Lord of the Rings. This is us coming to the top of this part of the glen. I know the second part, which is not as good as this bit, is actually closed and fenced off due to subsidence. So we'll be stopping once we get onto the forestry track up here, and then we'll be heading back down a different route.